That's the one.
Mr. Forbes and Mrs. Wilson want us to do today.
Well, good morning, children.
Good morning, Mr. Forbes and Mrs. Wilson.
Good morning.
Now, Mrs. Wilson, see, this is what I like. Children with good manners who treat adults with courtesy.
Exactly. There's not enough of that going around these days.
Oh, I have a great idea. Why don't you children focus today's episode on good manners?
How?
You can make sure that everything in the script is courteous, and you can research how these customs got started.
We are very pleased to do as you ask.
Oh, there are those good manners again.
Maya, it's a pleasure to have you here this morning.
That's a little formal, isn't it?
Well, yeah, but Mr. Forbes and Mrs. Wilson want us to practice on our manners.
You can have good manners and still talk like a kid.
Okay, I'll try again. Hi, nice to see you here this morning.
Nice to see you too. Would you like to get started with the show?
Yes, please. Maya, please roll the opening title sequence.
My pleasure, we're rolling.
Please take it. So nice to have you here this morning. Please cue the host.
Good morning and welcome to the Kidsongs TV Show, the one and only show made by kids,
for kids,
and starring kids,
and Biggles.
We've got a really great show for you today. I think you're going to be glad you decided to watch.
I agree. Debbie Gibson is our guest. Debbie sings, writes songs, and even appears on Broadway in plays. We're looking forward to meeting her a little later in the show.
Shouldn't we play a song now?
Yes, how about one with you in it?
That would be great. Do you have Little Red Caboose handy?
Sure do.
Little Red Caboose, chug, chug, chug. Little Red Caboose, chug, chug, chug. Little Red Caboose behind the train. Smokestack on its back, 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 coming down.
Care of it. Bye.
Everyone's talking about manners. What are they?
It's the way you're supposed to act with each other, being courteous and polite.
I don't get it.
Do you mean saying things nicely?
Yes, and respecting people's feelings.
Every society has rules of behavior, a right and a wrong way for people to act. And when people follow the rules, they have good manners.
I understand. Manners are about speaking and behaving nicely.
You've got it.
What courtesy do you mess up on the most?
thank you notes. Every time I get a present, I really want to write them, but then I keep putting it off, and then it seems like it's too late.
My mom's really strict on thank you notes, so I've gotten a habit of writing them the same day I get the gift. Then I'm done with them.
Thanks, Hassan. Maybe I'll try that. Alex, Aaron, if it's not too much trouble, could you please get us into the next song?
Sure thing. One of the most unusual-looking animals on the planet is the alligator. You can imagine them crawling around back in the era of dinosaurs.
But even alligators are cute when they're babies. So let's join the Kidsongs kids and alligators of all sizes in...
See you later, alligator!
Well, it's on my baby walking.
Follow the rules. But how do little kids learn the rules?
You learn from the people around you. Even little kids can learn to say please and thank you.
And you can show respect to your family by being on time for meals and sharing a chore like clearing the table. It's all part of having good manners.
Billy and I do all those things at home. So I guess we have some manners already.
Did you know that different countries have different customs? For instance, in Japan, you give your guests small candies and cakes on a piece of paper. To be polite, the guest has to take with them the food they didn't eat.
Since people travel to foreign countries so much these days, it's probably smart to learn about local customs before you go.
Speaking of going to a foreign country, Sakura, Sakura is cute and standing by.
Thank you. Cue the host, please.
Japan is a country with lovely old traditions. There are styles of dance and costumes that have been around for centuries.
The Kidsongs kids went there to see some Japanese girls perform the traditional Nihon Boyo dance.
Kasumi ka kumo ka, ni oi. know that the handshake goes back hundreds of years? Warriors did it to show that they weren't holding a weapon. It's a sign of peace.
Wow! I didn't know manners were so interesting. What else have you guys found out?
Manners have changed a lot over time. Less than 100 years ago in England, it was considered bad taste for a man and a woman to sit together on the grass.
You're kidding!
That was during the Victorian era. Things were really strict then.
I'm glad things aren't like that today.
Shira, let's count them in 3, 2, and...
When I was a little kid, I used to enjoy riding around my neighborhood in a little red wagon.
And that's exactly what the Kidsongs kids are doing in our next video. The song is called Bumpin' Up and Down.
In my little red wagon.
Bumpin' up and down in my little red wagon. Bumpin' up and down in my little red wagon. Bumpin' up and down in my little red wagon. Having so much fun. Here come my friends in the little red wagon. Here come my friends in the little red wagon. Here come my friends in the little red wagon. Having so much fun. Look at me in my little red wagon. Look at me in my little red wagon.
Very good manners?
Sure, it takes a while to develop them. Some kids don't pay attention in class or won't take turns riding in the front seat of the car.
And a lot of kids interrupt their parents, especially on the telephone.
Oh, there are so many things to remember. But it seems that they are all about behaving in a kind and thoughtful way.
Just like you do, Ruby.
Thank you, Brooke.
Inch your head, shoulders, knees, and toes is next.
Thank you. Is everybody ready on the floor? Good. Coming to the host in 3, 2, and...
This next video is a fun one to try to follow along with. It starts really simply. Just touch your head, shoulders, knees, and toes.
And before you know it, you'll be touching your feet, tummies, arms, and chins.
We go pretty fast, but if you follow along with Ruby and I, you'll do great.
Okay, everybody. Time for head, shoulders, knees, and toes.
Head and shoulders, knees and toes. Knees and toes. Head and shoulders, knees and toes. Knees and toes. And eyes and ears and mouth and nose. Head and shoulders, knees and toes. Knees and toes. Feet and tummies, arms and chins. Arms and chins. Feet and tummies, arms and chins. Arms and chins.
Multi-talented singer, songwriter, and producer Debbie Gibson has even appeared on the Broadway stage.
So to get us in the spirit, let's play our video.
Give my regards to Broadway.
Give my regards to Broadway. Remember me to Herald Square. Tell all the gang at 42nd Street that
it's question time. How about you?
Thank you for asking. I'm ready. Let's roll the graphic and take it. And please cue Alex.
Our guest today is a very talented lady who had her first success when she was just a kid.
At the age of 16, Debbie Gibson released her first album, which she wrote, produced, and of course, performed.
We wanted to know how one person could accomplish so much at such a young age, so we've invited her to visit with us.
Let's welcome Debbie Gibson and Lindsay Bartleson on Question Time.
Thank you, Alex and Aaron, for that very impressive introduction. And thank you, Debbie, for joining us.
Thank you.
How old were you when you first started?
Well, I was about 5 years old when I first started performing in community theater and talent shows, and 16 when I started recording my own music.
Wow, so how did you get started in show business?
Oh boy, well, I guess I tagged along with my older sisters to auditions, and snuck into a few myself and got the bug.
Was it hard to be a star and a kid at the same time?
Hey, you guys could relate to that. As you know, it's a lot of work to keep up with schoolwork and with your friends and your family, but it's definitely well worth it. So it was hectic, but it was okay. It all worked out in the end.
So how do you write a song?
Oh boy, that's a long story. A lot of times I'll get an idea or a catchy phrase that comes into my head, and I'll basically elaborate on it, expand on it, and try to turn it into something interesting, because sometimes my own life isn't that interesting, so I have to make stuff up. And I'll kind of sing my thoughts and write them down.
Wow, so is it true that you produce your own albums?
Yes, I've got a new album out called Think With Your Heart that I produced.
What does that involve?
That's a good question. A lot of people don't know what that means. Basically what it means is if you have the way that you want the music to sound floating around in your head, producing is about explaining that to the musicians, putting all the pieces together so that the songs come out sounding the way you want
awesome.
Them to.
So I hear you have a new album coming out.
Mm-hmm.
Could you show us a clip of the video?
Sure. I just happen to have one with me. Here's a little bit of the video for Better or Worse.
And when the angels came down, I'd say, don't you dare. You know not what you do. May God take me first for better or worse. I love you. May God take me first for better or worse. I love you.
Woo! That was great.
Thank you.
Finally, what advice do you have for kids who want to be songwriters or musical performers?
Well, I'd say just keep doing it, because there's no such thing as a bad song. If it's your song, it's your song, and you should be proud of it, and you should write as much as you can, as often as you can, perform your songs for your family and friends, and then maybe venture out into talent contests and things like that. And the most important thing is to stick with it, keep at it, and a lot of hard work, you'll succeed.
That's very good advice. Thank you so much for joining us
Thank
today.
You.
That was a very nice interview.
You know, Brooke, you were showing good manners when you said that. And you know that Lindsay and Debbie use good manners when they thanked each other. I think we have pretty good manners on this show.
Me too. Now, will you please step over to your studio, because it's time for your sing-along segment?
Oops! Ruby's waiting for me. That's not right. I'm late, and that's not good manners either. I think I've messed up.
Don't worry. Kids do mess up. It takes practice to remember all your manners.
Thanks. Bye.
Please cue Aaron in 3, 2, and...
Okay, kiddos. I hope you're ready to get up and dance a little, because I know two little Biggles who are ready to lead you in a sing and play along segment.
Billy and Ruby have picked a really good song for you today. It's called Personality, and I'm pretty confident that you're going to like it a lot.
So let's go to their studio for
Billy and Ruby Sing and Play Along.
I'm ready to dance, are you?
Sure.
Not you, Billy. I know you're ready to dance. I'm asking the kids at home.
Oh, of course they want to dance. Sarah, Sean, Emily. Phew, I'm relieved. Now that that's over with, what are we going to do, big sister?
First thing we're gonna do is walk with personality.
I can do that. What else?
let's try a little side to side.
I'm doing it! What else?
Just have fun.
All over and over, I tried to prove my love to you. Over and over, what more can I do? Da-da-da-da-da-da. Over and over, my friends say I'm a fool.
Da-da-da-da-da.
But over and over, I'll be a fool for you.
In just one more song.
I've got Happy Trails available. It's a nice way to say goodbye to our viewers.
Good choice, Maya. Thank you.
Is saying goodbye a manner too?
Sure is, little brother.
Then that means I'm showing good manners when I say goodbye to all the kids at home at the end of the show every day.
You sure are. Shira, it's all yours.
Alex, Aaron, please give us an intro to Happy Trails in 3, 2.
When I have to say goodbye to people I really like, I get a warm and fuzzy feeling inside. This song makes me feel the same way.
I know what you mean. Let's watch the Kidsongs kids and some of their country friends ride off into the sunset to the tune of
Happy Trails.
Happy trails to you until we meet again. Happy trails to you. Keep smiling.
Wrap it up. I'm ready for lunch and I'm buying.
Yay!
And cue.
Well, kiddos, that's all we have time for on this episode of the Kidsongs TV Show, the one and only show made by kids,
for kids,
and starring kids.
And Biggles!
What do you say we thank our viewers for watching us?
I think that's a lovely idea. Would you like to do it?
Yes, please! I'd like to take this opportunity to thank all of you for watching our show.
See ya!
See ya!
Bye!